Endometriosis is a medical condition where the endometrium, or the inner lining of the uterus, is inflamed. It is caused by, oftentimes, a hormone overload, especially with estrogen. Now, why is this important and how is it related to adrenal fatigue? In this video, we will go through it. This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com. Endometriosis is so common and is part of, as we said earlier, a continuum of hormonal excess, particularly the hormone estrogen. Now, when estrogen is in balance with progesterone, the woman will feel great. When estrogen is in excess, then problems arises. Now, estrogen is made in a few places in the body, including the adrenal glands, the ovaries, and the fat cells. So if you have a lot of stress, your adrenal glands can put up more estrogen. When you have ovarian dysfunction, the body's going to put up more estrogen. And when you have more fat tissues, the body's going to put up more estrogen. Where did the estrogen go? The estrogen helps a woman develop the body to be more female. In a monthly cycle basis, the estrogen builds up the endometrial lining, and therefore the menses becomes heavier. Many people experience heavy cycle bleeding because their estrogen level is too high. Now, the body does give you symptoms of high estrogen, and these can include PCOS, fibrocystic breast disease, endometriosis, and as well as in the last cases, endometrial cancer, etc. And not to be forgotten is fibroids. Now, as I said, endometriosis therefore must be explained in terms of an estrogen continuum where the estrogen output in the body is too much. Now, the estrogen excess can be related on an absolute term or in the relative terms. In other words, you can have a laboratory test and have absolute level of estrogen in normal range, but still have estrogen dominance because if you have less progesterone to offset the estrogen, then the estrogen level will go up. Now, most of the hormones as well as compounds in the body has opposing partners. For example, calcium opposes magnesium, sodium opposes potassium, copper balances with zinc. Now, estrogen is therefore balanced with progesterone. When you have low progesterone, then the same amount of estrogen will become high relative to progesterone, and therefore you have a situation called estrogen dominance that we refer to. This frequently occurs during the menopausal period where the estrogen level decline, the progesterone level decline even more, resulting in estrogen dominance. In the case of adrenal fatigue, the progesterone can oftentimes be shunted to downstream hormones such as steroid or cortisol, leading to estrogen dominance as well. Now, estrogen dominance is expressed in the body as endometriosis, fibrocystic breast disease, and fibroids, as we talked earlier. So a person can experience endometriosis, heavy period, PMS, and don't know what the cause is, but actually, if you trace it enough, it can be related to adrenal fatigue, as well as other possible causes. So endometriosis in itself may be very, very easily be treated by conventional doctors thinking that this is a strict hormonal dysfunction and given birth control pills and even in extreme cases, surgeries. But actually, endometriosis is a symptom. It is not a disease if you trace it deep enough, and you will find this oftentimes a connection with a female hormone imbalance that oftentimes is associated with adrenal fatigue. Now, many people can have endometriosis on itself without anything else. But in the case of adrenal fatigue, they are tied together. And knowing endometriosis, the role it plays within the adrenal fatigue continuum is important in your search for the right answer. And I hope you understand this. There's an article actually in my website called Estrogen Dominance, And I've written a book on that that you can look for. It will explain to you much more detail. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I've written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.